going to see the bacteria and this microorganism with respect to the O2 requirement. So we have anaerobes, facultative aerobes, and aerobes. The aerobic bacteria, they require completely the O2. This is tuberculosis, Bordetella pertussis, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, Bacillus, like Bacillus anthracis, Corynebacterium diphtheria, Antenocardia. Facultative aerobes or facultative anaerobes, this is the mainly requirement of O2 is almost like 100%, but they have other methods to utilize to do the metabolism, that is O2 independent requirement, would be facultative or could be other methods. This is Staphylococcus aureus, other staphylococci, and strep. Also some other gram-negative bacteria, but usually these ones. And the obligative anaerobes, these do not use O2, and they need a lot of carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide, and is the ABC mnemonic. So we have actinomyces, bacteroides, and clostridium. Actinomyces is a gram positive bacteria, usually with filamentous bacteria, and bacteroides is a bacteria usually seen in, for example, the colon or the mouth. And Clostridium, the genera Clostridium, could be Clostridium difficile, Botulinum, Pemphigus, or tetany. Alright, usually the anaerobes do not produce catalase, so these are catalase negative, and superoxide dismutase negative. As opposed to the aerobic bacteria, these usually are superoxide dismutase positive. In respect to this relation, we also have the enterobacteria. Enterobacteria usually is facultative bacteria. They are oxidase, cytochrome C oxidase negative, as opposed to the majority of the gram-negative bacteria. We have catalase negative sometimes. Usually the reduction of nitrates to nitrites, yes, the reduction. We have the only bacteria that can produce some UTI that do not reduce the nitrates into nitrites is the enterococci, but this is not an enterobacteria. So the enterobacteria are oxidase negative, catalase negative, and this reduction, and all are gram negative. In relation to catalase positive enzymes, just because I'm seeing this, and so I remember other things that I think that are important to know, the catalase positive enzymes are Nocardia, Staphylococcus aureus, Serratia, Pseudomonas, Helicobacter pylori, Bordetella pertussis, Actinomyces, Aspergillus, y Escherichia coli. Mostly, these are the gram negative or positive catalase positive bacteria.